Still, let me check whether now the message is coming to you. Recording is started. Now, thank you very much for.
30 मिनट से चल रही है।
हाँ, नॉट एन इश्यू. वी विल कवर इट इन अवर कोर्स ऑल्सो. नो प्रॉब्लम. सो लेट मी चेक वंस अगेन. ओके. So here you have seen different different characters. Okay, the characters are starting from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and these are the special character. Whatever embedded in this null means 0. This 0 is different from one more 0 is given here. That is, yes, this is actual 0. Okay, this is actual 0, which when we place it in right hand side of any number, it will just increase its value 10 times, and if we divide, decrease the value 10 times. But this null is different. It means nothing. Nothing means empty space is there, and so many different characters are there depending on their uses. Now special character starts from 33. 33, that starts with exclamation and so on. Okay, so this is the code known as American Standard Code for Information Interchange. Now you have seen that how to write hello. All these things, if you see in computer's language, okay, if you see in computer's language how it looks, let me show you. If it is available, then I will definitely. Okay, let me show you in you a text file how it is stored. Okay, so what is the process? How do I start to write? Because text is text, so there is no problem. Let me show you Word file. Notepad plus plus. Okay, so now I am going to show you Notepad plus plus, and inside that Notepad plus plus, you will be able to see how the programs are looking like. Okay, how the things are looking like. So here, this is a special editor. I am opening one image file. Okay, image file just in C drive. I had created one image file, algorithm flow, interest in C program. Okay, now here you can see several ASCII characters. That null is also given here. Is it visible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. Now
No, sir.
you can see that very means, you know, a special kind of characters you are visualizing here. Correct or not? You are unable to get what actually it is. So this is written in language of C, and if you see what actually is written, let me show you. Show you open. Yes, so let me share my desktop this time, so it will clearly show you. This is the diagram, this is the picture. This picture is written like this. Clear? So who will convert this picture? The dedicated program. So how do we convert this picture? So we need to write a program, because this is a special format and something written in header. Header will tell that this program is. That's why we have put the extension as PNG or JPG, whatever. Okay, so this comment line shows that this is a PNG image and this is header. This is image header, I header, and the software is written. Some software is given, and if you change this information, okay, if you change this information little bit, only one character. Let me change this particular block. I had deleted this block. Okay, I had deleted this block. Only PNG will be there. And let me save as some other name. So algorithm in C, modified dot PNG. Okay, so this is saved here. Now this program, this particular file is saved here. This is the file I had modified. Now let me try to open it. It will not open. Algorithm flow interest in C.png. It looks like it don't support this format. Why this happened? Because we don't know anything about the language. Because each and every line tells computer something that what is the meaning of these lines. And I had deleted that line. So that's why different format and the same file, it is there. You can see this whiteboard, and you can open with Notepad also. Again, I can open with Notepad also, but without affecting this, there is no problem. If I affect a single bit, okay, I had tried before also in my college days, one COBOL compiler was there, and I had opened the executable file of that compiler. Okay, so there I saw COBOL. So I had erased the COBOL and I had written COPIL. Okay, because COPIL has different ASCII character and COBOL has different ASCII character, although length are same, but when I started this program once again, it won't started. Okay, why? Because I had cleared the information. So all these informations are stored, all these information are stored in a specific format, okay, supported by a particular machine or particular program. So for suppose paintbrush is an example. So paintbrush won't open txt file, but it is able to open svg file, png file, jpg file, and bmp file. All these files are supported by this paintbrush. Okay, similarly Word can open .doc, .docx, etc. So this is very important thing, and all these things has been supported with the help of these ASCII characters. So this is not sufficient. If you want to write, suppose my name you want to write, okay? So this consists of Devanagari, okay? So how do I write, how do I support Devanagari Lipi? For this purpose, Unicode is there, okay? Unicode is having 32-bit character set, 32-bit character set. It simply means that we have flexibility of 2 to the power 32 characters. If we calculate, then the answer is 4 giga words. Okay, 4 giga words are very, very sufficient for writing any kind of languages. So that's why this Unicode supports Chinese, whatever font. And that's why it is asking for Unicode font. Okay, sometimes it is asking for a Unicode font. Okay, so when we are using ASCII, then it requires to write hello, it requires 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8 plus 8, that is 40 bit. Okay, and to write in Unicode it requires 32 multiplied by 5, and that is equals to 160 bit. Okay, or you can simply say that 5 byte is sufficient to write hello in ASCII code, but in case of your Unicode it requires 20 bytes. Okay, clear? This concept is clear why number system is important?
Yes sir.
Okay, so this is, yes,
if it requires Arabic code, sir, you say
yes.
Yes, sir. I have problems, sir. First, batana sir. Numbers, why number system is important?
I'm not getting you.
Sir, first, batana. Ye jo apne bataya ki why number system is important for us.
Okay. Why this Unicode number takes 20 bytes to write hello?
Yes, sir.
Okay. See, there are different languages in world. Agree or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, you all are agree. Now, before, when we used computer during 97s, 98s, so whenever I used to write anything in Hindi or English, so many messages are there, maybe in Hindi also. So let me show you these messages. Like this name is in front of you. Okay, this is WhatsApp. Inside that WhatsApp, it is running in Windows. Okay, and inside that Windows, you are able to see that this name is written in Hindi. Okay, some other languages are also supported by this, but I have very limited friends of different languages, so I am not having any. Like Marathi and Hindi is same Devanagari, they are using same Devanagari phones. Otherwise, there are Marathi languages also. Fine. So up to this, okay, only 56 characters are there in Hindi language, and 26 characters are there in, means 52 characters are there in which language? English language. Why 52? Because small cases and capital. So 52 for English, then for Hindi also 56 characters. For Urdu language, how many characters are there? I don't know. Okay, maybe 26, 28 characters are there. Then again, so many things are there. So these are the characters. Then there are means different dots. And punctuation symbols are also there associated with particular language, like in Urdu, Nukta is there, in Hindi, Matra is there, okay, in English, phones are there, phonetics. So, if we extend all the languages, the number will be more than 10,000, okay. So, how to store this number? To store this number, we require a larger character set. We are not able to limit our character set to this ASCII. So for this, we have a larger branch, and this is known as Unicode. So in Unicode, one character require 32 bit. It simply means that 32 divided by 8, so 4 byte. Okay. Similarly, for ASCII, it requires only 8 bit or 1 byte. Okay. If you write hello, it requires only five bytes in case of ASCII. And in case of Unicode, it is multiplied by this, 5 is multiplied by 4. How much it is? It is 20 byte. So now I think you understand why this is much information is required. Is it clear, Harsh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, this is all about character codes. So, these character codes are developed by American Standard Code for Information Interchange. Okay. We have our own code, ISCII, ISCII. ISCII, now let us see whether ISCII is in existence or not. ISCII India. So this is Indian Script Code for Information Interchange. Okay, what is ISCII? This is Indian Script Code for Information Interchange. So these are the character sets. Here you can see ISCII Devanagari Lipi. So in this Devanagari Lipi, there are different character sets available. Okay, so how many, what is the size of this character set? So this is 16 bit. Okay, so this is 16 bit encoding. Give me a minute time to remove this noise. Now am I audible? Noise is not there now?
No, sir, you are audible.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, you are audible. Okay.
So, like American Standard Code for Information Interchange, we have our own code. Okay. Nowadays, it is not used, and it is used with some Krutidev or some other fonts. But in Google also, you can see that Unicode font is supported. Okay, so Google Translate, not Translate. Okay, here also you can see, suppose I am putting here PQRST, Telugu. So suppose I am writing one in English. So what is the meaning of one in Telugu? This is Okati. Okati or Okati. I'm not able to. Then two. Two is written as Rendu. Three. Okay. Mudu. And similarly, when we go for Hindi language, EFGH. Yes. Now, three is written as Teen. And this also gives us fonts, how to read this particular language. And this is also given. Okay. So here, this font is Unicode font. Okay. This is Unicode font supported by Unicode. It is not supported by Indian Script Code for Information Interchange. And here you can see that total 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 up to F. It means it requires 16 bit storage. Okay. And there are 16 multiplied by 16, whatever number is there. So these many possibilities are there. So to write this code, we need to use equivalent number. So here for null, it represented by 0000. Then 0001 is SOH, STH. So this is one quad. Okay. This number shows. Each number shows, suppose this delete number, or let me use some other number. Suppose a anarka is given here. So a anarka ke liye, what we need to do, just put the number, and what is the storage? How it is stored in binary? Because this number is written in hexadecimal, so it is very easy for me to write in. Don't try to understand that how I remember this thing. Just try to understand that how do we write it in binary. So this is 4 times 0. Then 9 is written as 1001. And 0 is again written as 0000. And 5 is written as 0101. So that's why to store this Unicode number or Unicode font, we require 32 bit. For Hindi or for Hindi and all other Indian languages, 2 to the power 16 is sufficient. Although we have so many languages, but 2 to the power 16 is a big number to accommodate all the language. Similarly, in case of Unicode, we have 32 bit. So total 4 giga word we can store in for this Unicode font. So I think this importance of code, you are able to understand. Okay. So there are some other codes, and I will tell you some different codes also. So here you can see, and what are the languages supported by this ASCII code? So Assamese, Bangla, Devanagari, Gujarati, Gurmukhi, Kannada, Malayalam, Odia, Tamil, and Telugu. Okay. And ASCII does not encode the writing system of India based on Persian, but it is writing system switching codes nonetheless provided by Kashmiri, Sindhi, Urdu, Persian, Pashto, and Arabic. Actually, these languages are written from right to left. Okay. So for this purpose, it uses the Persian based writing system, and it is encoded as PASCII encoding. Okay. So now I think it is very clear to you that what kind of encoding you require, it depends on whatever language you are using. So here it shows that the Brahmi derived writing system have similar structure. So ASCII encodes letter with the same phonetic value at the same code point, overlaying the various scripts. For example, ASCII code 0 cross B3, it means hexadecimal, it is written in hexadecimal, or 0 cross DB represent key. And this will be interpreted as key in Malayalam, key in Devanagari, key in Gurmukhi, and key in Tamil. The writing system can be selected in rich text by markup or plain text by means of the ATR code described. Different ATR codes. This is the ATR code, equivalent code. I had shown you that how do we write an ARCA. That is 4 times 0, 1001, and 4 times 0, and 0101. So this is our an ARCA, and so on. So this different blocks are given. And that's why we must understand that why sign number, why unsigned number, why sign characters, and why unsigned characters impacts on programming. Okay. So you can ask any question related with this. Any other question in future? What are the things are futuristic question like in future? What will happen in computer science? And you can ask. No questions?
No, sir.
Okay. So yesterday you have tried to download this book, Mastering C. Okay. So I know this is not downloadable. And some softwares are there. By using this, you can download. But nowadays, internet connection is very good. So there is no problem using these things. So you can, okay, let me one more thing. For attendance, you are struggling. So many persons are struggling for attendance. So I will show you how do I mark my attendance. Okay. Initially, I start with this screen is visible to all of you. Initially, I started with this downloading the attendance list. Now this list is downloaded in download folder. Okay. The first meeting attendance 14. This is today's date. And I am having one more file that is attendance list. Okay. So I will open this Excel sheet. Now this Excel sheet is open. I will also open the attendance list. Okay. So my attendance list is this role list, and I will delete this and this also. And this is the complete role list provided by me. Anyone is enrolled in yesterday's class or yesterday? No idea. Okay. So let me copy this in another tab and paste this over here, and then select all these attendance. And I need to delete my own name because my name is, there is no meaning of this name in attendance. Now go to this data tab and remove all the duplicates. So it will remove all the duplicates because so many names are given in so many times according to their appearance in my class. Now total attendance is 58. If you see in this meeting also, so it shows 55 and plus 3 guests. Okay, 3 guests are there. So where are the guests? The guest appearance of one Kamal Jat is there, and one more person. So let us see how do I mark attendance. So here this attendance is available. Now I'm going to sort this attendance. Okay, this attendance list is sorted, and this is for the person who have attended my classes, my class, or who have enrolled in my class. And now I will paste here. Okay, this is A section's attendance list. So I am going to copy control shift down, control C, and then paste here. Okay, so I will cross check up to what mark it is coming. Okay, like Ankit Shekhawat is there. Now this Ayush is there. So due to this Ayush and not Ayush, up to Anurag Mishra, okay, Arpit Agrawal. From this Arpit Agrawal, I need to insert one and cell shift down. So this fellow is absent. Anurag Mishra is absent. Nahin, Anurag is present. From Ankit Shekhawat, Anjali is also there. Aniket Goyal, Agarwal, Porwal here. Okay. So actually Ankit Porwal is absent. Now tell me whether Ankit Porwal is present or absent. Ankit Porwal is there?
Not.
Fine. So how do I prepare attendance for you? This is the way. And Ankit Porwal with 96 Ankit. Okay. Now let us see. Ankit Shekhawat is there. Bharadwaj is there. Agrawal, Mishra. Then Arpit Agrawal is also there. So I need to delete this. Delete and cell shift up. Now Arvind Kinshuk. Ashruj. Ashruj is not present. So let me shift this insert and shift down. Fine. So Ashruj with 84 Ashruj. Then come to Ayush Paul. Paul is also absent. Now tell me, Ayush, this ID Ayush 05915.
Yes, sir.
Whose ID is? Yes.
Sir, it is your registration is a problem. Yes.
So this is your ID? This is your ID?
Yes. No, sir.
This is not your ID, na? You are Ashush Paul, Ayush Paul, na?
No, sir. Ayush Agrawal, sir. Maybe, sir. Yes, sir. Ayush 059.
This Ayush 059 is Ayush Agrawal.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So what I do here, every time I need to paste this in different cell. Okay. Now, because Ayush Sharma is there and Ayush Paul is absent, I think. So let me write Ayush Paul as absent. Let me mark absent 1, 2, 4 Ayush Paul. Now,
sir,
Ayush Sharma.
Sir, yes. Aapne Ayush ka nahi ID Arpit Agrawal ke aage likh di galti se.
Arpit Agrawal.
Yeah. Ayush ki jo guest ID hai, wo apne Arpit Agrawal ke aage.
No. There is no meaning of this. This is written separately. It is not corresponding. Okay.
Okay. Sir.
This is for my understanding. It is just corresponding thing. Ayush. Because later on, maybe one Ayush is there. So I need to use that. So this is not related with any of the left hand columns. Okay. It is independent. Fine. Because this is a convenient place for me. So I had pasted here only. Now, Chirag, Uma Maheshwari, and then Dhruv is, yes. So here, from which place, Deepak Chauhan is absent, okay? Insert, his name is there. I had heard several things about this fellow, but to write Deepak Chauhan, 79 Deepak. Still here it's, now, everything is clear. Dhruv, Harsh, Himanshu. Now Harshvardhan Sharma is also absent, but his name is given here. So let me insert and down Harshvardhan with 20. Okay, then now this is also, I am not getting the name, so I am pasting here. So it is not corresponding to Arvind Kaushik. Arvind Kaushik was absent yesterday. Okay. Then Jubit. Jubit is there. Jisha is also there. Hitesh. So Himanshu Yadav is absent. Himanshu Yadav with 128. Okay, so I need one more minute and then you can ask any question. Hitesh, Jisha, Jubit, Kavardeep, Karan, Kaustubh, and then this Kritagya Hiran. Okay, I have no idea of this fellow, so I need to paste here and then delete this cell, delete and shift up. Okay, now everybody is present. Saurabh Appu. So only five fellow are absent. Ankit, अश्रुज, आयुष, दीपक, हर्षवर्धन एंड हिमांशु. एंड आई ऑल्सो राइट द नेम ऑफ दीज फेलो स्पेशल अपियरेंस आयुष 05915. ओके, दिस फेलो इज आयुष अग्रवाल. ओके, एंड देन कमल जाट एंड देन कृतज्ञ हिरेन. Fine. So any doubt related with attendance? So this is how I am marking attendance. So anybody who is saying that their attendance was unmarked, so due to this problem, if you are using with some other ID, then I am unable to get those person. Okay. So today we have a lot of discussion. Just enroll in your class and I will start computer programming. Tomorrow one more class is there, or no class? We have all three classes done in this week.
Yes, sir. Class is done.
Okay, so let us form the batch, and there is no restriction. Okay, the batch with mixed language, both the person can attend in any of the batches. This is open. Both the batches are open for all. It is for my convenient only, that how many of you are interested. So there is a result. You can also see the result. Give me one more you have two more minutes. So let me show you. There are 64 responses. Out of these 64 responses, 54 plus 70% persons are interested in mixed medium, and only 28% persons are interested in English class. Okay, so these are the two different batches, and how many responses are there? So 18 responses for English, and for mix 11 plus 35, that is 46. Okay, so this is my motto, and I am not showing names of any person. So you process if you have any doubt, and you can attend any one of them. Fine. So now I think it is sufficient for today. And
so what will be the timings for classes?
I'm actually, this is programming, frankly speaking. So if it is in morning session, it is well and good. But it depends on you. If you are attending this class for your own convenience, that okay, I will attend. So during evening time, it is very difficult to create a logic.
So please take it in morning only.
Yes, Muskan, your voice is not high.
Sir, please take it in morning only, because till evening we are tired at all.
That's why, because it is not class for formality. It is not class for formality. That's why I'm asking that. See, momentum of this class is as it is. So don't compare this class with any other class. This means whatever is regular classes. Only compare the classes which I am taking additionally. Okay. This is according to your slayer. Yes.
Those classes will be on Sunday and Saturdays, right? If morning, no, because we don't have any other.
No, actually, for at least 1 week, I need to take it in weekdays also.
But we won't have any free time in morning in weekdays, because we have different classes.
सैटरडे संडे को इवनिंग में रख सकते हैं क्लास, मॉर्निंग में
भी रख सकते हैं सैटरडे संडे को. सर, यू कैन टेक कंटीन्यूअस क्लासेस.
नहीं नहीं, वो मैं बिल्कुल समझ रहा हूँ, लेकिन आपको इस हफ्ते तक भर केवल 8 to 9 यू कैन अटेंड फॉर दिस वीक ओनली. फॉर दिस मींस एटलीस्ट 3 क्लासेस यू नीड टू अटेंड 7 टू 8. No, I'm also not comfortable. 7:30, maybe 8 to 9 you need to attend. Only this week days.
Okay, sir.
Only this, okay, sir. This week means at least up to 3 classes you need to attend. And then we will start taking class in Saturday and Sundays. Fine.
Okay.
So just by today's evening, I will plan out all these things. And timing will be 7 to 8, not 7 to 8, 8 to 9, because my one more classes are there. Okay. From 6:30 to 7:30, or maybe sometimes it is going up to 7:45. So that's why I need to take your classes. I will check what will be the possibility, and then only we will go accordingly. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So I will post. I will give you update on by today's evening. Fine. So thank you very much. Have a nice day, and just post your problem in that group and join. All the persons, whether they are newcomer or not, they need to join in that group only.
Sir, fine? But two batches banenge na, ek total English ka aur ek English plus Hindi ka. Then haan. Sir, dono ki timings kya rahenge? Dono to morning mein bhi nahi ho sakte fir.
Nahi. See, first 3 days English plus Hindi, and next 3 days English only.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, and once the momentum is there, then we will take only in Saturday and Sundays.
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, I will post. Actually, common group is okay. There is no problem with common group. Only problem with timing. So, I will write the timing. And both the persons from English medium, persons from Hindi medium, they can join both the classes. There is no restriction because no attendance is will be considered there. Okay, so there is no restrictions also, but I will take attendance for my convenience that these many fellow has attended the classes, extra classes. So I need to actually, whenever the college authority or university authority ask what you have done for the students who had joined late. So for this purpose, I had created one extra class, and we have taken extra classes for the students who have joined late. Okay. So thank you very much. Bye bye. Have a nice day. Have a nice time. And yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
And post your problem in common group. Okay. Post your problem in privately. If and if you want to post it privately, better to call me. Okay. Fine. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.